Alright, so I forgot to pack my blanket and my pillow, so I had to stop. It looks kind of loud.
You okay?
Better than ever.
I had to stop.
My girl.
And get a pillow and blanket for the adventure. And this heater here, a little buddy heater. This is kind of scary. When you light it, there is definitely like a poof of flame, you know, 3 to 4 inches above it and around it. So be careful when lighting this in the vehicle. The windows need to be cracked pretty wide open for the smoke detector to not go off. And then let's see if I shut my little lantern off, maybe we can see the back view. So that's the back. It's gonna be pretty in the morning. And then, you know, got my goodies in there. Oh, can't see. Got my goodies in here. Good to go. Alright. So, ta-da. Winter overlanding. Whoop, whoop.
What is up, guys? Finally making a video just for you, Brenda. No, but seriously, this was my first winter overlanding camping trip, and I decided to drive 4 hours into a snowstorm to see what it is I really need for my winter camping excursions.
Winter camping!
So I decided to drive 4 hours to Illinois to a nature preserve that had a abandoned mine situation going on it. And I tried finding it, however,
hiking around for a few hours with no success left me to move on to the next place, which was a canyon about 20 minutes away. And it was well worth the trip, even though I didn't get to see the abandoned mine. Maybe next time.
So in the meantime, this nature preserve was my stopping grounds. I camped in here about 4 miles into it. Nobody was there, big surprise, right? But I had a blast playing around there all morning, looking for this abandoned mine. I did about 5 mile hike. I was unable to find it. I searched the whole area. I don't know, it would probably be easier in the spring, I'm sure. In my travels of looking for this, I managed to find this really cool old car. It was pretty neat. I thought it was really cool. All the buttons were still there. I thought it was just going to be the shell, so it was pretty exciting to see some of the cooler, older aspects of it were still on it.
Okay, so I'm trying to find some mines. Some abandoned mines, and it says to drive across a big ass field. Now, I should probably walk across this big ass field, but I'm gonna drive across it. So, field. I could drive across this field and then park somewhere in here and walk the rest of the way, and there should be some abandoned mines in here. Alright. I mean, it says no hunting. It doesn't say no driving, right? So this is the field we're driving across that I'm probably not supposed to be on. Drove across the field, and now we're gonna follow this instructions through the woods to go find an abandoned mines by some little river.
So here we go. Through the woods we go. And then I walked around for a couple hours looking for this shit and I could not find it. So it was pretty disappointing, but I tried. The adventure itself was still fun looking for it, and the best I could find were these mushrooms. That was the highlight of this trip. So I had to then go leave, and like I said, I found this really cool canyon. Down here, see these little circles? That there is like a little cavey situation. So I was all the way at the top and I had to hike 5 miles down into the canyon and back up into it. So that was a really good time. This here is the top of the canyon. They put a big gate here so that people like me don't fall into it. This here is a better picture of the caves at the very top of the waterfall. I kind of got my way up to the fence and kind of stuck my camera through the fence so we could see a really cool view of the canyon itself from the top of the waterfall. And like I said, I have to hike all the way down that canyon and then back up to the canyon. So it was a pretty far hike and it was very tiring, especially in the snow. So as you can see, I hiked over to that fence over this little bit of water and I saw this little rock here, which was cool because I know I'm not the only one who wanted to play over there. It's one of those painted rocks that you find on trails from other people who do crazy stuff like you do. It was pretty exciting. I did totally take it home.
Spot. Hiked about 2 miles to the beginning of the canyon, and we're gonna walk through the canyon and check it out. This was an extremely long walk, and I'm glad that there was a bunch of holes in this cave canyon situation, because I think I would have been pretty disappointed if I walked all that way and the caves weren't pretty exciting. And to me, I think they were 100% worth the hike, and I hope you enjoy them. I'll hike to them and then I'll go through the holes and you can see all the holes in the caves and the top of the waterfall, and then hike on back. Thank you. All right, we made it.
See, I told you guys that was a long walk, but we're finally here.
All right, so that's where we were, up there. Looking down at these guys. There's another hole. This is pretty neat. This looks like a really fun place to hang out in the springtime. Bet you this place is packed with people. All right, that was worth the adventure.